Yo, what's good, everybody? It's your boy Malcolm, and I'm back for another video. And in today's video, I'm going to be giving you guys a spoiler-free review of the new movie Transformers 1. So this weekend, me and my girlfriend went to go see Transformers 1, and I'm gonna be honest with you guys. My expectations were set pretty high because I'm a huge Transformers fan. I'm not super deep into the Transformers lore like a lot of people. A lot of people read the comics and know everything about every single piece of Transformers lore there is. I'm not like that. I've watched all the live action Transformers movies. I've watched plenty of animated Transformers TV shows, and I've owned a lot of Transformers toys when I was a kid. I'm not super deep into it, but I do know a lot. But here's the cool thing. I didn't know shit about the backstory between Megatron and Optimus Prime. When the trailer came out and I found out that Optimus Prime and Megatron used to be friends, I was shocked. I was very surprised, and it made me pretty excited for the movie. One, because Chris Hemsworth and Brian Tyree Henry are both incredible actors. Brian Tyree Henry is actually my favorite male actor of all time. I think he's incredible, but just the chance to get this story and learn more about it excited the hell out of me. After I saw the movie, I loved it. I thought it was absolutely incredible. If I had to give the movie a rating out of 10, honestly, I would probably give it a solid 9. One of the reasons why I feel like this movie was so good was because of like the live action Michael Bay Transformers movies. Just like every big monster movie, they always try to add a certain aspect of humanity in it. They feel like they have to add humans and make the humans the main focus in order for the audience to care. I don't know why they feel like that, but that's always what they want to do. So they always add an extra storyline of Sam Witwicky or the Mark Wahlberg ones. So the main focus is never truly the Transformers. The Transformers always end up as background characters. But in this, in an animated universe where there are no humans and it's just the robots, that's what we wanted to see in the first place. We don't give a fuck about no damn humans. We see humans every single day. We see humans when we look in the mirror. I want to see big giant robots, and I want to see their story arcs and see what goes on with them. So I think this movie did it really well because it was only robots, and that's all I gave a fuck about. Not only that, but having the opportunity to go back in time and learn about all these characters that I've known and loved but didn't know all this about. I didn't know about Optimus Prime before I thought he was always Optimus Prime. I didn't know that he started off as Orion Pax. I didn't know that Megatron started off as B, whatever the fuck the numbers were. I had no idea about any of that. I didn't know Bumblebee wasn't always cool. I didn't know any of this shit. Now, I've always known that Sentinel Prime is a little shaky on the moral side and he's kind of a dickhead, but even this gave me more background into that. So seeing that, also a huge positive of the movie, and seeing Cybertron was awesome. Honestly, I wish we would have got to see a little bit more of Cybertron. We saw some of it, but I wanted to get deeper into it and see what was really going on Cybertron. But if there is another movie, which I'm sure there will, because I know this movie is going to be highly successful, I think that movie will give us a lot more of a look about Cybertron and what's going on over there. I know I've spent a lot of this review talking about the animation, and the animation was fantastic. I just think that animation is always going to be one of the best ways to tell a story. I'm tired of seeing live action things with things animated in it. Just give me something fully animated. But in that same vein of talking about the animation, the choreography was great. There were a lot of fight scenes, a lot of high speed moving action, blah, 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 all that. And they did it great. There were many times where I felt like I was there when they're racing or rolling out or fighting or boxing. You can really feel it and it looks realistic. You can feel the weight of the punches behind them, the sound design. You hear the metal crunches, the cracks. It was really, really good. The choreographers and the sound design team did their thing on this movie. Now, I've watched every Michael Bay Transformer movie up until this point, and there are some very good ones, especially Dark Side of the Moon. That's probably my favorite one. But this movie, I think it's better than all those. This is probably the best Transformer movie that we have gotten. So if you haven't seen it, I highly recommend going to see it. Even though I do feel like this is the best Transformers movie, I do have a couple issues with the movie. those issues do have spoilers. So if you want to hear a little bit more about the things that I found wrong with that movie, go check out my other video that will either be posted later today or tomorrow, where I kind of go more in depth into the actual movie and the spoilers, and I can talk a little bit deeper. But for the people who haven't seen it and just want to know whether to go see it or not, I'm telling you right now, you should go see this movie. It was really good. If you're a fan of Transformers and know a lot about Transformers, you should see it. If you don't know anything about Transformers, you should go see it. Or if, like me, you got a good amount of Transformers knowledge, but you don't know everything, you should go see it. This movie was really good, and you are going to have a good time. And it's fun for all ages. You can see it with kids, or there are some more mature jokes and things like that that adults will get. Great movie. I don't have many complaints. Have a couple, but I'll talk about those in my spoiler review. Thank y'all so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. I'm out. Peace.